Okay, I'm inspired now, and I'm going to dad disco dance. I don't know how to do it.
Oh, that was great.
Oh, yeah. No Dancing with the Stars next year for
me. It's like auditions.
What about you? Give it a whirl. Show us your disco.
I was just going to do that move, what that guy did, but I just, no.
Oh, you're chickened out.
I'm going to practice it. We'll do it tomorrow.
He's chickened out. Yes, we're going to say,
that was a good segue.
Wasn't it? Yes, chicken. That's what we're doing today. Gumbo, Cajun chicken.
Yes, we've got a gumbo on the menu today. So this is a classic dish from New Orleans. That's sort of South American, sort of spicy stew, basically, made with chicken. We've got some ham in there as well. Some nice vegetables, the celery and the green capsicums, and lots of spices as well, paprika, chili, and Cajun spices through there. So a nice winter warmer for this time of the year.
Yeah, great one to make tonight. We'll take you through those processes very soon. It'll be nice and easy, and if you don't catch, you can always go back and watch it on 3Now. Great to have you with us. We are in the Beko Kitchen. Thank you very much. And if you think your drinking habits are causing you problems, we'll be chatting with internationally renowned hypnotherapist and author Georgia Foster about how we can cut down on the booze, which is probably for a lot of us something we need to look at. It's going to be great. I'm really looking forward to it. But right now, time to get cooking. You've got pots and pans on. It's gumbo time.
That's it. Pots and pans are on. You can make this all in one pot if you want. If you've got a big enough pot. But I'm going to start the gumbo in a smaller pot, and we'll do the chicken separately, and then we'll add it. So I'm going to give you a tip now on how to cut down on the oil for cooking.
Here's a tip on how to cut down on the oil for cooking.
Right, chicken, so dice it up, that's your job.
Okay, cool, I'll just wash my hands quickly.
Put you to work.
Yep.
Right, so we're going to dice the chicken up, so nice chunky pieces.
Give me a tip then. So do you cut it that way or do you cut it that way?
Yeah, so cut it in half.
Cut it in half?
No, long way, sorry.
Oh, yeah, okay, cool, yeah.
Yeah, that's it. And then you can go across and you get nice nice chunks. So obviously there's a fatter part of the chicken.
Yeah.
So you can do sort of a bit more.
Oh shoot. Like that?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Nice and rustic, nice and chunky.
Okay, it's
a
bit, cool.
It's a sort of a chicken and vegetable, spicy chicken and vegetable stew. Beautiful, that's it. So then once you've chunked it up, pop it.
Once I've chunked it up.
We even make new words up on the cafe.
No, I was just concerned because I've been to your restaurant, the O'Connell Street Bistro, and...
We don't chunk up things.
No, you're very fine there. It's beautiful, isn't it? So I was just making sure that I was doing it right. But that's a good tip about cutting it this way.
Yeah, that's good, yeah. Right. So then once you've got all your chicken cut up into the bowl, give it a good seasoning with salt and pepper.
Okay, so
and then
speed
pop
up.
The oil over the chicken in the bowl, and then you can stir it around. And once you've got a nice coating, you're ready to go in the pan.
Okay, cool.
And then you can see the pan is really, really hot.
It is really hot. Okay.
And then we can pop it straight in, and then it's going to sear it straight away.
Okay, so this is here now. So what are we doing?
Yeah, salt and pepper and oil. Cool. I'll put the oil in. So just a little bit, and then you can stir it around.
Nice.
And then just so it's nice and shiny. Right, and then you can pop it in there. So you've probably got enough chicken to do in the large pan, so you can all go in there. And you'll get that sear straight away. And you can see you've got no excess oil in there.
Yeah, that's great.
There you go.
Thank you, chef.
So we're going to pour the oil, what we say, we're going to put it in the other pot. No, we're not. Right, so another little pot here. I'm going to start with the onions. So nice and chunky, nice and rustic. I've got some celery there as well. I've got some green capsicums. And all we're going to do is just take the cheeks off and just cut it into nice chunky pieces, you know. It's very rustic, it's very chunky, it's very textured sort of stew. You can see you're getting a nice bit of colour on there.
Yeah.
That's good. It's all going to cook together, so we're not looking to cook it. That's why we're using a really hot pan. We're looking for a nice bit of colour on there.
Okay, cool. Yeah, the hot pan's made a big difference, eh? Searing away nicely here.
Yeah, definitely. If you don't hear that noise and you don't see that colour after sort of a minute or two, your pan's too cold. If you see lots of liquid coming out of your chicken, it's bubbling, it's not good. So the best thing, take it out, wipe your pan off, heat the pan up so it's smoking, and then start again. And start off with a little bit of salt and pepper in here with the onions.
Did you put some oil in there, did you?
Yeah, there's a little bit of oil in there.
Cool.
And then we're just going to stir them around, break the onions up, and then we're going to pop our celery in and our capsicums in as well. And then going to cook them for about 5 minutes just to sort of slightly soften them, get all those flavours going. And then once the chicken's brown, we're going to add everything into one pot and cook it all in one pot.
Oh, nice. Okay. Well, things are looking fantastic. Looking brilliant. smelling great as well. And if you like things a little bit spicy, make sure you head to our Facebook page for your chance to win a caddy of these four authentic sauces from Cholula. Okay, really cool, world famous. Win yourself some right now. We need to finish off this gumbo. Chicken's going nice.
Yeah, beautifully browned chicken. You can see the vegetables are sort of starting to sort of soften. This stage now, we're going to pop some flour. So flour goes in, we're going to toast that, and that's going to help thicken the soup.
Okay.
And then we've got some spices. So we've got Cajun spice in there as well.
That goes in. Oh, we need that, because it is Cajun chicken.
It is, and that's going to give us some flour. So get it all.
That's a really interesting mix you've got going on there. Yeah. Okay, now you're the chef.
Right, and then we've got so you've got all these spices in the Cajun mix, but I always like to add a little bit more.
Cumin.
So a little bit more cumin.
Yeah, I thought it would be.
Paprika.
I've worked out cumin and coriander just about in everything, isn't it?
Flavour makers.
Yeah.
And a little bit of chilli.
Okay, cool. Nice.
Right, and then some bay leaves as well. Bay leaves go in there. And we're just going to toast that over the heat for a couple of minutes. Bring out the flavour of the spices.
Okay.
And you're almost toasting that flour as well.
I can smell it. You're right. With the toasting, you are releasing all those flours. It's very nice. Well, I can get a whiff of that bay leaf too.
Right, and then we've got some chicken stock.
Okay, well, that makes more sense now.
So now we're going to pop it in. So just be careful, and you want to be stirring this as you go. A little bit at the beginning.
Won't it get a little bit lumpy?
Well, no, that's why we add a little bit in and keep stirring it.
Okay, good. Just checking.
And then, you know, once you've got it all in and you make sort of a little bit of, you know, like a loose paste, you can pop the rest in.
Okay, cool. And there, look at you, no lumps.
Oh, there you go, yeah. Wow. Professional. So I didn't get you to do it.
Oh, harsh.
Right, so we're going to bring that up to the boil.
Yes.
You can pop the chicken in there now.
Yeah, that's the right colour. So the chicken doesn't need to be cooked all the way through.
No, we're not cooking it all the way through. Yeah, all the juices in as well. You know, that's all flavour as well, you know. Don't waste those.
Okay, cool.
And then we've got a nice bit of ham here now. So nice chunky sort of squares of ham. You know, you can use a smoked ham. And then that goes, this is going to go in just near the end of cooking, because this is already cooked, which is going to give us some extra flavour. So bring it up to the boil, turn it down, you can pop a lid on there, you know, cook it out for sort of like an hour or so, nice and slow.
And the ham, when are we putting the ham in towards the end?
Towards the end, yeah, and the last sort of like, you know, well, the last probably sort of half an hour, actually.
Brilliant.
And then you'll get all the flavours, and then we've just got some spring onions, we're just going to chop the tops.
Yep.
So nice and green, nice and fresh, just before serving, that goes in, and there you go.
Nice work.
That's it. Check the seasoning, a bit more salt and pepper, and boom.
Brilliant.
Any sauce in if you want a bit more spicy. But nice. There you go. A winter warmer.
You don't want to put any of that Cholula sauce in right now? No?
Oh, we'll save it for the end.
Okay, at the end. Nice. Okay, don't forget you can win some. Just go to our Facebook page. This is going to be delicious. And, of course, the recipe is always at the website, thecafe.co.nz. This gumbo smells and looks amazing, Mark. Look at that.
Yeah, it's quite well.
Beautiful. Ooh. Love the little garnish of the spring onions. Okay, what are you doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow we've got Singapore fried noodles.